What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Suppose we have an integer array with distinct values sorted in ascending order. Now, prior to being provided with that array, it is possible that this array was rotated at an unknown index. For example, the first array you see in front of you might be rotated at index 5 to become the one below it. So, given the array after the possible rotation and the target integer, what we must do is return the index of the given target if it is in the array, or minus 1 if it isn't. Okay, a lot of people may start by jumping to the easiest solution anyone can think of, and it is searching for a value linearly in the given array. All we need is a single for loop, and as soon as we encounter the target value, we return with its index. Others may go one step further and cut the complexity in half by traversing this array with the help of two pointers simultaneously. Great, but that's not what the question is about. Both these solutions are linear in time, regardless of the approach you picked. Additionally, we didn't even make use of the rotation criteria provided to us by the interviewer. These solutions work for an array, not just this one. What we need to find is a customized approach to tackle this specific rotated array, and that is exactly what the interviewer is looking for. Remember, always try to make use of and leverage constraints given to you by the interviewer as much as possible. So, how are we going to search in that array in a manner faster than a linear approach? Well, if you've watched the previous video of this series, you may recall the one covering the binary search technique, and that is exactly what we need here. As a reminder, binary search allows us to search for a specific value in a sorted collection or array in log of n time complexity. But the catch here is that the given array is rotated, i.e. not sorted, so how are we going to apply binary search on it? Well, maybe the whole array isn't sorted, but most of it is. You see, if the array is rotated as we previously mentioned, then any provided array can be divided in half as you can see in front of you. And this means that we can apply binary search on this chunk of the array as it is sorted. Let's go through an example and suppose that the target value index we are looking for is 5. So, by cutting this array in half, we made sure 100% that one of these subarrays is sorted. And if we manage to identify which one of these subarrays is sorted, then we can apply binary search on that subarray. If we find the target value, then great. If not, we are now sure that it is most probably located in the second subarray. So, we can go ahead and apply the same logic all over again on that subarray, meaning we slice this subarray into two, and after identifying which subarray is the sorted one, we binary search the target value inside it. That's it, we found the target we are looking for. To implement this solution, we are going to start by cutting the given array into two. Then, if we're lucky and the target value we are looking for is in the middle, all we must do is return it. However, if it isn't, we need to identify which chunk is the sorted one. And this is done by comparing the first value to the last value of that chunk. So, if the first value is smaller than the middle one, then the first subarray is sorted. If not, then the second half is. After identifying the sorted subarray, we need to check if the target value is in that array or the other one. Meaning, if the first subarray is sorted and the target is in that subarray, then the right reference should move, allowing us to rule out all the elements in the right part. Similarly, if the second subarray is sorted, but the target is not in that subarray, meaning it is in the first one, then the right reference should move in a similar manner as well. The same logic is replicated if the target value is in the second subarray, so whether the first or second subarray is the sorted one, the left reference should move to rule out all the elements in the left part of the first subarray. Okay, the logic we wrote will attempt to search for the target value in the first two subarrays or first two halves only. To keep slicing and searching until we find it, as we mentioned, this same logic needs to be wrapped in a while loop. And if the loop ends without returning the index we are looking for, then the provided value does not exist in the whole array and minus 1 should be returned. This is it, the complete and optimal solution to the given problem. The link to the lead code exercise we solved today can be found in the description below. Let me know your thoughts and suggestions for upcoming videos in the comment section. And that's it for today. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.